Okay guys, so welcome to the channel, and I'm gonna bring in a file to print a part for my surfboard, and it's just a handle, but it's for a Chevy, and I'm gonna bring this in. Okay, it comes in big. I'm gonna scale this. I already know the size I want. It's a 160 mil, so I'm using Creality Print Slicer because it has the profile already of the Ender 3v3ke printer that I've got, and I'm just using CRPLA normal quality. I'm not gonna mess with, you know, too many settings up here at the minute. Here you've got a slider, you can see the level of print going on. But anyway, I'm gonna do a test print of one of these, and I've just thought I'd show you a little bit of the slicer software. So if you've got a Creality printer, I was using Cura before. Cura's good, but this has got the profile ready to go for the printer. So I'm just gonna now, as you see under here, it's not red anymore, but it normally comes up red where you need supports, and I will need supports here. So I'll go to support. Okay, I'm just gonna create automatic supports. Oh, I'm gonna create, and that automatically fills that in for you, which is kind of nice. And so really I'm gonna go with that, and I'm just gonna print one, and if it doesn't go right, it doesn't go right. I'm gonna slice this now. Click on slice. Now it says the model has not been supported and may fail to print. Do you want to continue adding supports before slicing? Now I'm not sure where it's asking me to add any more supports here, so I think we're good. I think it's just a generic kind of thing coming up here. Print speed, it's on 50. I'm gonna leave it on that. It's gonna do a bit of a brim, it's gonna infill. Okay, well, we'll go with that also. Retraction, so it's all kind of just gonna do its own thing, right? Now I'm gonna just export to local, and we're gonna go into the USB drive. We'll go with that, right? It's gonna save it in there. Save finished, open local folder. Let's open it, have a look, make sure. Chevy, there it is. That's the file you get in the key with the printer. You get a USB key, and there's supplementary files, I guess. I haven't unzipped that yet. I designed the grill, guys. You'll see that in upcoming videos. So we're done. We're coming out of here, and I'll take you through the print now. I'll show you the print. I'll speed it all up, and we'll get to the end result. See what we get. Let's go. Okay guys, I've been having power cuts today, so I lost the first clip of me taking this off, but I took the supports off, left a little bit behind, but that'll clean up. Just so you know guys, if you have a power cut with this printer anyway, it just asked me to resume the print. I tapped resume and it carried on, and I was very happy, so I didn't waste, well, I suppose I have wasted plastic because I'm not going to use this one probably, but it's going to be carbon, that, you know, it could be used. But yeah, the printer does carry on after a power cut, which was for me a good thing, and for you to know. So there we go. Came out okay. I mean, there's a few little bits and bobs, you know, that could be better. I'm out of breath. I've just come in from putting the power back on. So yeah, I lost the video, a bit of a shame. But basically the supports came off fairly well with a bit of a blade and sandpaper, that would clean up. So yeah, there you go guys, just another little video on the Creality slicer, and now we know guys, it does print after a power cut. There we go. I'm gonna leave you there, and hit the like buttons for me guys, help the channel out, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks a lot. Bye.